It's been a thrilling ride for the last 19 years, one that we hope to continue with gusto for the coming many decades. Among the big news makers kicking off the next year for us are PSU banks. Joining us now is Sunil Mehta, the MD and CEO of Punjab National Bank, India's second largest public lender. Mr. Mehta, afternoon, and thanks so much for taking the time out and speaking to CNBC TV 18. I want to start with the policy first, because in the policy, RBI has asked banks to link all the floating rate loans to external benchmark. According to you, what will be the impact? Will it result in volatile NIMs? Do you see the risk going up on account of that?
First of all, my greetings to the CNBC TV 18 on completing 15 years of its existence. And the question which you asked is a recent monetary policy based, and its implications are going to be very positive in the economy. As regards to the linking of this to the external benchmark, you know, the bankers have already moved from earlier of PLR based lending, then to the base rate based lending, then to the MCLR based lending. So every time the system adopts to a new change, the pricing dynamism also converted into the market dynamism. So ultimately, when it will be linked to the external benchmark, accordingly the NIMs can be maintained by adjusting the pricing of the resources which we mobilize. And ultimately, the banks will have to maintain a required NIM to undertake their operations and maintain the viability. So ultimately, this will lead to a better transmission of policy rate to the ultimate borrowers, especially those who want to avail the facilities and create the projects. And in the process, this will go for repricing of the existing liability products also.
Okay, all right. So the transmission of the benefit to the users as well is something that we'll be looking out for. Mr. Mehta, sir, the other point that we're looking at is in terms of buyouts of NBFC loans. We had the SBI chairman who joined us earlier today, and he was talking about, you know, buying out nearly around 45,000 crore worth of NBFC loans. Do you have any kind of number in mind for PNB Bank? What's the strategy out there?
Yes, we are also a party to it. We have already purchased a portfolio aggregating 1,500 crores, and we have a plan to purchase up to 4,000 to 5,000 crore during the current financial year.
Okay. If you could also talk about the asset sales, because that was also a part of PNB's plan for FY19 to raise money. So how much have you raised so far, and how much do you think you will be able to raise by the end of FY19 or by the end of this year?
So by the end of this financial year, we have already planned to raise sale of non-core assets, and we are expected to mobilize roughly more than 6,000 crore during the current financial year.
Okay, 6,000 crore. And what about the PNB Housing Finance stake? Because the last that we've picked up from our sources is that private equity players like Blackstone are also interested in picking up stake, and they're looking at valuing PNB Housing Finance at about 5,000 crore rupees, your stake. Your comments on that?
So I'll not name anybody who is interested, but I can take a lot of investors have shown interest into it, and our negotiation and the process is going on, and I'll be able to comment on it when we finalize it. But we are on the advanced stage of processing it.
So in FY19, we can assume that this stake sale is going to take place?
Yes.
Okay, all right.
Yes, that is the way it has been planned.
Okay, so we'll take your word on that one then, sir. You know, that the PNB Housing Finance stake that you'll have, that's PNB has in PNB Housing Finance, that'll happen in the next 3 to around 4 months. Tell us about business as well. What kind of a loan growth are we looking at for FY19, and what's the outlook like for FY20? Some part of the street believes maybe a 7 to 9% will be possible.
Well, for my bank, if you see my domestic loan book growth, so during the second quarter, so first half year, we have registered a YOY growth of 14%. But that may be because of the lower base during that period of time. But we are hopeful to maintain a level of 10% during the current financial year.
Okay.
And what about credit cost? How do you see that in the, you know, the last second half of this financial year?
I think the credit cost is going to substantially come down because the stress asset management vertical, which has been created by our bank, and I think most of the PSBs in line with the Manthan decisions. So the ease agenda, we are going for implementation. So large number of manpower has been deployed. The recovery has become a prime focus of most of the bank, and my bank is leading into it. The first quarter, our recovery was highest in the industry. And that was, if you look at the percentage to the impaired book we have, so 8,445 crore was in the first quarter, and the good work continued in the second quarter. And the third and fourth quarter, now resolutions from NCLT are also expected. So I hope the good numbers will work out and the slippages will go down.
What kind of recoveries are we looking at for the second half of the year, sir?
Second half of the year, if all these resolutions which are in the NCLT and at the advanced stage of completion, so we are hopeful to get them in the latest by Q4, my total recovery from this along with my regular recovery will not be less than 8,000 crore.
And SR steel resolution would be part of this, right? What's the expected recovery
yes,
from there?
Yes, SR and yes.
Okay.
Yes, SR and Bhushan are a part of it. What's the right number I'll give you?
Okay. Mr. Mehta, I want to go back to that sale of non-core assets. I remember a couple of months back, you had indicated that the sale of non-core assets would fetch the bank close to about 8,000 or 8,500 crore rupees. Now you're talking about 6,000 crore rupees. So there has been a markdown in that, in the amount you were looking to raise, right?
So there... I think if you see the equity market, I'm giving you a conservative estimate, because if you see during the last 3 months when we talked about, the market has moved. So according to market, the realizations will happen.
Okay. Also, there has been a significant reduction in the 10-year bond yield. So they've come down by nearly 70 basis points in a span of about 2 months. So that should benefit your portfolio. If you could talk about the M2M benefits or mark-to-market benefits, you will realize...
Yes, definitely. Even now, we have booked a very good treasury profits, and the mark-to-market losses have been brought down because the depreciation has been plowed back, and we are going to get an upside of roughly 275 crore as of now. And this will further depend upon the price movement during the remaining part.
Okay, Mr. Mehta, very quickly, this is the final question from my end. The PCA, there's so much of talk that there will be certain banks that will be coming out of PCA. Your comment on that, is there any update on that front?
Well, it will be premature for me to comment on it, because that is a matter being examined by our regulator RBI, and they are going to take a final call on this. So I think I'm not privy to those deliberations.
But there's no update on that front at all?
I don't have any update as such, because ultimately the matter is being deliberated at our regulator level, and they will have to take a call on it.
All right. Thanks so much, Mr. Mehta, for stopping by and giving us all those details. All the best for the month of December as well as for the fourth quarter of this year. Well, on that note, then we'll slip into a short break. You come back, we'll talk more about the markets as well as stocks in focus. Stay with us.